Let us study fixed point and floating point formats. In order to process the real world data, the digital signal processor uses either a fixed point format or it may use floating point formats. In fixed point format, the data is in 2's complement integer format, and it manipulates data using integer arithmetic. Floating point processor represents number using mantissa and exponent. In floating point formats, it uses mantissa and in fixed point format, integer has very narrow dynamic range. Because of this very narrow dynamic range, sometimes overflow occurs. But floating point format has wider dynamic range. Let us study fixed point format. Consider four numbers 0, 1, 2 and 3. These four numbers can be represented by two binary bits. We can represent 0 as 00, 1 as 01, 2 as 10 and 3 as 11. Now instead of representing 0, 1, 2, 3 in 2 bits, we'll try to represent each of these integers in terms of 3 bits, where the another bit is used to represent the sign bit. Suppose the sign bit is 0, that indicates number is positive, and if sign bit is 1, the number is negative. Let us write the table for this 3-bit representation of a number. We'll make two columns. This is decimal number and one more column is binary representation, which is in 2's complement form, because fixed point format uses 2's complement format of data. Decimal 3 can be represented in 3 bit of binary as 0, 1, 1. This 1, 1, 1, 1 is, we can represent 3 using 2 bits as 1, 1. Along with I'll use one more bit to represent the sign. Here the number is plus, so this is 0. 2 can be represented as 1, 0. The number is positive, so I'll write it as 0, 1, 0. 1 can be represented as 0, 1. The number is positive, so it is 0, 0, 1. Similarly, 0 can be represented as 0, 0, 0. Minus 1 can be represented as, we know 1 minus 1 is nothing but 1 with minus sign. So 1 can be represented as, in binary, 1 can be represented as 0, 1. Taking 2's complement of this, we'll get 1's complement of this number is 1, 0. Adding plus 1 gives 1, 1. So now this is minus 1. So to indicate minus, I'll use one more bit, that is 1. So minus 1 can be represented as 1, 1, 1. Similarly, minus 2, as we know, 2 can be represented as 1, 0. Taking 2's complement of this, take 1's complement of this, that is, we'll get 0, 1 plus 1, that is 1 plus 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. So 1, 0, the number is negative, so I'll write one more 1 here, that is 110. So minus 2 is equivalent to 110. Similarly, minus 3 can be represented as 101, because 3 can be represented as 11. 1's complement of this is 00. Adding 1, it gives 10. The number is minus, so I'll append 1 to the prefix. So minus 3 is nothing but 101. Similarly, minus 4 can be represented as 100. So now here, if you look at the dynamic range of the numbers, here the dynamic range varies from minus 4 to plus 3. I can write here. Dynamic range is minus 4 to plus 3. The basic digital signal processor operations include multiplication and addition. Sometimes the result of the multiplication or the addition cause overflow problems. Let us try to understand one example. We'll try to perform the multiplication between 2 and minus 1. We know 2 can be represented in 3-bit format as 010, because 2 is equal to 010. I can write 010. Minus 1, for time being, we'll consider it as 1. 1 can be represented as 001. Now we'll perform the multiplication between these two numbers. Later, to get the negative result, we'll take 2's complement of that number. It is as good as multiplying 2 with minus 1. I'll perform the multiplication. 1 multiplied with 0 gives 0. 1 into 1, 1. 1 into 0, 0. 0 into 0, 0, 0. Similarly, multiplying 0 with these 3 bits will give 0, 0, 0. Now adding, we'll get 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. So this is the end result after multiplying 2, that is 0, 1, 0, with 1, that is 0, 0, 1. Because we supposed to multiply with minus 1. So now I'll take 2's complement of this number to represent negative. So first, taking 1's complement of this gives 11101. Adding 1, it results 01111. So now I can say 11110 is the result after multiplying 3-bit binary numbers, that is 010 and 001. Now let us restrict our result to only 3 bits. So here the result is having 5 bits. We'll truncate the extended 2 sign bits. So these are the 2 extended sign bits. I'll ignore these 2 bits. Now I can represent the result as remaining 3 bits, that is 110. So now, comparing this 110 with this table, so 110 is exist here, corresponding decimal input is minus 2, so it is nothing but minus 2. So now I can say that when 2 is multiplied with minus 1, 2 is multiplied with minus 1, I suppose to get minus 2. So now I can say, even though after truncation, I got the correct result, that is minus 2. Now I can say that minus 2 belongs within the dynamic range, that is minus 4 to plus 3. That's why we got correct result and there is no any overflow. Let us consider one more example. Let us multiply 2 with minus 3. In 3 bits, 2 can be represented as 010. Plus 3 can be represented as 0, 1, 1 for time being will ignore carry, will multiply 2 plus 2 with plus 3. We'll perform the multiplication. 1 into 0 gives 0, 1, 0. 0, 1, 0. 0, 0, 0. Adding, we'll get the result as 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Now we'll take, since we should get the result in negative, we'll take 2's complement of this number. First take 1's complement. It gives 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. Adding 1 gives 2's complement. That is 1 plus 1 is 0. Carry 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Now let us restrict the output to 3 bits. We'll truncate or discard the extended 2 sign bits. So now the result is, actual result is 0, 1, 0, but which is plus 2. But actually when we multiply 2 with minus 3, I suppose to get minus 6. But here we are getting the answer as plus 2. Because here overflow occurs, as this minus 6 does not within the dynamic range. Because our dynamic range is between minus 4 to plus 3. Therefore, in such cases, the overflow occurs. We can say that overflow. Now, to overcome the overflow problem which occurred in previous method, now let us design a system treating all the decimal values as a fractional numbers. Now we consider signed Q2 format. In signed Q2 format, each decimal number is represented as a fractional values using 3 bits of binary numbers. That is, each decimal number is represented by fractional number using 2 bits, and one more bit is used to represent the sign. If the number is positive, we will use 0. If the number is negative, we will use 1. In Q2 format, the number is normalized to the fractional range, that is fractional range in Q2 format is minus 1 to plus 1. The range of numbers is divided into 2 raised to 3 intervals, and the difference between each interval or the size of each interval is 2 raised to minus 2. In Q2 format, the most negative number is 1, whereas most positive number is 1 minus 2 raised to minus 2. This 2 because it is Q2 format. In Q2 format, any result from the multiplication is within the fractional range minus 1 to plus 1. Result range is minus 1 to plus 1. Now let us write the table to show 3-bit fractional representation of number. Let P, the decimal number is 3, which is taken in previous table. Decimal values are, let be 3, 2, 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and minus 4. In Q2 format, the decimal fraction number can be represented as 3 by 4. That is, in Q2 format, each decimal number is divided by 2 raised to 2. That is 3 divided by 2 raised to 2 gives 3 by 4. Similarly, this gives 2 by 4. This is 1 by 4. This is 0. Minus 1 by 4. Minus 2 by 4. Minus 3 by 4. And I can write minus 4 by 4, which is nothing but minus 1. Now let us represent each decimal fraction in terms of binary. We know that 3 by 4 is nothing but 0.75. The 0.75 in binary, 0.75 in binary can be represented as, we'll multiply by 2, we'll get 1.5. This is, first bit is 1, next 0.5 is multiplied by 2, we'll get 1.0, that is 1. So now I can represent 3 by 4 as 0.11. Similarly, 2 by 4 can be represented as 0.10. 1 by 4 can be represented as 0.01, and 0 can be represented as 0.00. It's very simple here. 3 can be represented as 11, 2 as 10, 1 as 01, 00. All are positive numbers, so these all bits are 000. Now minus 1 by 4. Minus 1 by 4 is similar to 1 by 4, representing in 2's complement form. So if we represent 001 in 2's complement form, we will get 111. So we can write it as 1.11. Similarly, minus 2 by 4 is same as 0.10, but represented in 2's complement format because of negative sign. So by taking 2's complement of 010, we will get 1.10. Similarly, 3 by 4, taking 2's complement of this, will get minus 3 by 4, that is 1.01, and minus 1 can be represented as 1.00. Now we can observe here, these all numbers are negative numbers. Here we have received the sign bit as 1111. So in this case, the dynamic range of fractional numbers is varying from minus 1 to 3 by 4. So now I can say here, this is the dynamic range. That is minus 1, this is minus 1 to plus 3 by 4. Now we can observe here, Q2 format, the numbers are divided into 2 raised to 3 intervals, so that we'll get 8 intervals, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here the most negative number is minus 1, yes, here we have received minus 1, and most positive number is 1 minus 2 raised to minus 2, that is nothing but 3 by 4. We'll perform the multiplication between 2 and minus 3. As we know that 2 and minus 3, in previous case, it has produced overflow. Now we'll consider the same number. By seeing the previous table, we can represent 3 in fractional number as 0.10. And 3 can be represented as 0.11. Now let us perform the multiplication between these two numbers. This is by multiplying plus 2 with plus 3 number, we'll get 0.0110. Since we are multiplying, we suppose to multiply with minus 3. Now I'll take 2's complement of this number. Taking 2's complement, we will get the actual result. That is, first take 1's complement plus 1. So here the actual result is 1.1010. 1.1010 can be represented as minus 1 multiplied with a positive number. Now let us take the 2's complement of this number to consider the positive value. So 2's complement of this number gives 0.0110. That is, here this is the positive number. Multiplying with minus 1 is nothing but taking 2's complement of this. So 2's complement of this number is 1.1010. Now we'll try to convert this number into decimal. I can represent it as 0 into 2 raised to minus 1 plus 1 into 2 raised to minus 2 plus 1 into 2 raised to minus 3 plus 0 into 2 raised to minus 4. It gives minus 0.375, or we can write it as minus 3 by 8. Now let us verify this result. Here 0.10 is nothing but, in fractional numbers it can be represented as 2 by 4, and 0.11 can be represented as 3 by 4. Now we will perform the multiplication with minus 3 by 4. So it gives minus 6 by 8, which is equal to minus 3 by 8. So here we obtained result is also minus 3 by 8. Therefore, I can say that the number falls within the dynamic range, so there is no overflow occurs. But we have observed that the same numbers multiplied in previous format has produced the result overflow. Now we'll try to represent the result in 3 bits. Equal to 1.1010, there are 5 bits. We'll restrict it to 3 bits by truncating last 2 least significant bits, so that I can ignore these 2 bits. I can represent the result as 1.10. So this 1.10 can be represented as minus 1 into, we'll try to represent 2's complement of this number, which is nothing but 0.10. That is, minus 1 multiplied with positive 0.10 gives 1.10. So here if we convert this number into decimal, we'll get 1 into 2 raised to minus 1 plus 0 into 2 raised to minus 2 results in minus 1 by 2. Now here we can observe that by considering 5 bits, the result obtained was 3 by 8. After truncation, the result obtained is minus 1 by 2. So thus, there occurs a truncation error. We can call it as truncation error. Let us find the truncation error with respect to the same example. That is, here after truncation we got the result as minus 1 by 2 by considering 3 bits. By considering 5 bits, we got the result, that is minus 1 by 2 minus of minus 3 by 8, which gives 1 by 8. Now we can observe that in Q2 format, that is in Q2 format, error should be bounded by (2^-2), which is nothing but 1/4. So now I can say that the result 1/8 is, after truncation, is less than 1/4. So it is acceptable. In such case, it does not produce any overflow. Now I can conclude that fractional arithmetic can avoid or can prevent the overflow problem which was occurred in previous case. Now let us add these two numbers, that is 0.01, let's add with 0.11, we will get the result as 1+1, 0, carry 1, 1+1, 0, carry 1. So here we can observe that the first number is positive, the second number is positive. After addition, I suppose to get the result should be positive, but in this case I am getting the result as negative because the sign bit is 1. That is, the result is negative. The result is negative. Thus, I can conclude that signed fraction arithmetic partially solves the overflow problem.